Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. This is part 5 of synthetic division, and we're going to do the following problem. This one's a little bit tricky because this is a linear factor. There's no x squared term. So it's okay, 2x minus 3. But the problem is we have this 2 in front. All right, so we're going to start out the same. We're going to go ahead and set that equal to 0, what we're dividing by. And if we solve it, we get x equals 3 halves. So we're going to go ahead and put the 3 halves in the box. But here's the trick. At the end of the problem, you must divide the quotient by the coefficient at end of problem, divide each coefficient in quotient by whatever that coefficient of x is, which will be 2. So in this case, it's going to be 2. So how would this work? We go ahead and put the 3 halves in the little box. This one's a little more complicated, right? And let's see, we've got these in order because we've got the x squared, the x term, and the constant. So I just write those out, 2, negative 9, and 8. And those of you who, fake it with fractions, nope, you got to remember how to do fractions here. Here is our remainder box. So we start out. Bring the first term down as usual, and we multiply by what's in here. Now, if you can't do that in your head, just go over to the side. What's 2 times 3 halves? And let's see, the 2's cancel, don't they? So 3 is what's going to go up here. And then we add these two. Negative 9 plus 3 is negative 6. Then we have to multiply that by 3 halves. So let's do that over here in case you can't do it in your head. What's negative 6 times 3 halves? Well, it's going to be negative something, right? Because there's a negative sign. And then 2 goes into 6 3 times, so that's going to be negative 9. And it looks like negative 1 will be the remainder. But now we have to pay attention. At the end of the problem, divide each coefficient by in the quotient by that 2, okay? Whatever this is, you have to divide these coefficients by that number. That's the trick. No one ever taught me that when I did learned how to do synthetic division, so I didn't know how to do problems like this, but I figured it out. And it's kind of cool. So these are our new coefficients. So this is our x term, our constant, and our remainder. So the coefficient for the x term is 1, right? So it's 1x. So our answer is going to be x minus 3 plus negative 1 over what I divided by. Now go back. What was the original problem you were dividing by? It was 2x minus 3, right? That was the actual problem, 2x minus 3. So 2x minus, not a good minus sign. We'll do another one of these on the next video, but first let's check our answer and make sure we got it right. All right, so here was our original problem, 2x squared minus 9x plus 8 divided by 2x minus 3, and it looks like our answer should be x minus 3 plus negative 1 over 2x minus 3. So how would you check it? We take what we divided by, 2x minus 3 times the x minus 3, and then add the remainder. So let's see if that works. 2x minus 3 times x minus 3 plus the remainder. Remember, the remainder is just negative 1. It's just that thing goes up on top. Okay, do this using the FOIL method on your own and see if you get this when you're done, right? That's what we're looking for. So we've got 2x times x, 2x squared. Outer is minus 6x, inner minus 3x, last plus 9 plus negative 1, and That is 2x squared minus 9x plus 8. Yahoo! So this is the correct answer. Okay, before going on to the next video, just keep in mind that division might not always look like this with this little division sign. You might see it written as 2x squared minus 9x plus 8 divided by 2x minus 3. That means the same thing. The answer is still x minus 3, and you could write plus negative 1 or just put the minus sign in front of the fraction bar, 2x minus 3. You want to get used to seeing the answer written different ways, the original problem written different ways. They all really mean the same thing. Okay, so we'll do another one like this on the next video. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.